What's up guys, it's Tundrum here, back with another video. Today I'm going to be showing you my Boros Feather Pionner deck. Now this deck, it's based around casting heaps of spells that say target creature you control, get something. And then all your creatures have benefits such as heroic, or whenever you cast a spell on a creature you control, return it to your hand with Feather. And it can make some really insane and aggressive combos. Combo with some powerful heroic cards and a few cards like God's Willing and Reckless Rage, this deck is a top tier Pionner deck. Without further ado, let's get into it. First up, we're running two Echoing Crusaders. Now these are a pretty solid card. It's a 1 mana 1/1 creature human soldier, and whenever you cast a spell that targets it, you get to create a 1/1 soldier with haste. Solid, can create us heaps of bodies when we're casting spells on it. Four favored hoplites. This is really good. It's a 1 mana 1/2, and it has heroic. Whenever you cast a spell that targets it, put a 1/1 counter on it, and then it becomes immune to all damage until end of turn. This, whenever we're casting repetitive spells on it, plus the normally pump spells, this can get titanic. It's a great card. And next up, we've got Monastery Swift Spear. Four copies of it. It's a 1 mana 1/2 haste prowess. Because we've got heaps of non-creature, cheap non-creature spells we'll be playing heaps of, this can also get really massive and is a good aggro card to go with our aggro theme. Next up, we've got four Reckless Rage. Now, Reckless Rage is an insane card. It pretty much just says, 1 mana, target a creature you control, so you get its target trigger, and deal 4 damage to target creature opponent controls. This is super insane because we have heaps of those heroic triggers, and it deals 4 damage, a solid removal. Next up, we've got God's Willing. This is super solid. It also targets our stuff, plus it protects it from removal, plus it can make it unblockable or immune to damage, plus it lets us scry. This is one of the best cards that really makes the deck run. It's really powerful. Next up, we've got Titan Strength. It's a 1 red for instant, and it gives target creature control +3/+1 and trample until end of turn, and you get to scry one. Solid card. If you play this on, let's say, something like a favored hoplite, it suddenly becomes a 5/5 on turn 2, or 2 of them, and then it's a 9/9. That's insane. It's a super solid card. Next up, we've got 2 Dreadhorde Arcanist. This is a solid card. It's a 2 mana 1/3, and it says when it attacks, you may cast target instant or sorcery spell from your graveyard with Cavern mana cost less than or equal to its power without paying its mana cost this turn, and then exile it. So this gets us heaps of our stuff back over and over. Super solid card, card advantage. We're running 4 Tenth District Legionnaire. This is similar to Favored Hoplite. It can get super huge, and it gives us heaps of scry triggers. It's got haste, super solid aggro, insane powerful card. And then finally, in our creatures, we have Feather the Redeemed. Now, Feather the Redeemed is the bomb in our deck. She's a 3 mana 3/4 flying, and she says whenever we cast an instant spell that targets a creature you control, exile it as it resolves. If you do, return it to your hand at the beginning of the next end step. This is insane. If we have, let's say, something like God's Willing, then our creatures all have permanent protection. If we have something like Reckless Rage, that's suddenly infinite removal, super solid card, insane. Need to be running this. Next up, we're running 4 Boros Charm and 4 Defiant Strike. Defiant Strike is super solid. It's a 1 mana instant. Target creature you control gets +1/+0 until end of turn, and you draw a card. With Feather, this just keeps coming back and giving you infinite cards, plus it's a good pump engine, and it draws you a card, even normally. And then Boros Charm is really good. It can deal 4 damage to target player for 2. Goes really good to finish enemies off. You can give all your permanents hexproof, which is super solid against, like, removal, and you can give target creature you control double strike until end of turn, which is probably its best bit, because this then can make, let's say you've got your favorite hoplite, and this is maybe a 3/3, and then you place a Titan Strength, then it becomes 7 power, and then you place that, then you suddenly got an absolutely titanic swinger, insane card. Now we're on to the mana base. 4 Inspiring Vantage and 4 Sacred Foundries, they're the best lands, but if you can't afford them, just replace them with basics. Then 3 Mountain, 3 Plains, 3 Battlefield Forge, and 3 Clifftop Retreat. These, the bottom 2 lands, the 3 copy Battlefield and Clifftop, they're both relatively cheap and solid lands, so if you can get them in, they're a great include. Now finally we're onto the sideboard. We're running 2 Gideon Blackblade to help us against control strategies, or aggro strategies as well. He's pretty good against most things. Weir to Teir to deal with any artifact or enchantment shenanigans. Rest in Peace to deal with graveyards. teaming a Battle Rage in case we need a more big trampley double strike creatures to trample over token based builds. Three copies of Fry, super solid against Teferis and things with big blue and white creatures. And this is a card I have never seen any other feather deck anywhere run, but I think it's really good. Four, Fall of the Hammer. Now this is a 2-mana red instant, and it says target creature you control deals damage equal to its power to target creature you don't control. I reckon this is super good. With a feather, it's just as good as a Reckless Rage, infinite recurring removal, and it can often hit things for massive, and it targets our creature. I reckon it's a solid 2-drop removal, and I reckon it definitely belongs a spot in the sideboard, maybe even in the main. And yeah guys, that completes my list. Hope you enjoyed the video and found the deck helpful. If you want to see more from me, make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and yeah, peace out.